Hi guys, welcome to Tech Interceptor. Okay, today we'll discover this. This is the new motherboard by Asus. Precisely, this is the Asus Prime B650M-A AX. But first of all, remember to subscribe to the channel, activate the notification bell to stay up to date on upcoming videos, and if you want to take a look at our Twitter and Instagram profiles. Let's start! The motherboard of which we talk to you belongs of Asus Prime series. Together with mobile, into the box we find the always the precious user manual, 2 set of 3 6 GB second cable and various other things such as 1 Wifi antenna set, 1 IO shield and 1 screw package for M2 socket. Although, without doubt, it is absolutely an entry-level board, but it is to underline that it doesn't leave out the technical aspect. The new Asus board has a micro-ATX form factor and its size 9.6 x 9.6 inches or, with the international system of a unit, 17 x 17 cm. All components leans on the black PCB but do it base. Printing on it there is a contrast white colored solar system with also some planet like the Saturn. Moreover, our some words such as Asus and the name of product. The wall board is a cooling through few silver metal brush heat sinks. One with a very simple profiles covers only the MOSFET present on the left of a CPU socket. The piece feature the word Prime that indicate the membership to the Asus series. Instead, wheels on top of this latter are uncovered. The second and also the last heatsink. It is little and square and also this is literally essential to its duty. On contrary to the previous and main heatsink, this is enriched with Asus logo and some curvilinear line which resumes wheels of a PCB. Regarding to the power design, the VRM layout is composed by 8 plus 2 power phases. These allow to guarantee the maximum power and efficiency. As all new B650 board, also this feature the new AM5 socket and support whatever AMD Ryzen 7000 series desktop CPU. At the moment, the new Amd Raphael series include 4 SKU, that is the Ryzen 5 7600X, Ryzen 7 7700X, Ryzen 9 7900X and the Ryzen 9 7950X. Specifically, in terms of specs, are a little bit different from each other. The Ryzen 5 7600X has a 60 core and a 12 thread, 5.3 GHz of a boost clock, 4.7 GHz of a base clock, 42 MB of cache, all with a TDP of 105 watts. Follow the Ryzen 7 7700X with 8 core and a 16 thread, 5.4 GHz of boost clock, 4.5 GHz of base clock, 32 MB of cache and 105 watts of TDP. The Ryzen 9 7900X has a 12 core and a 24 thread, 5.6 GHz of boost clock, 4.7 GHz of base clock, 64 MB of cache and 170 watts of TDP. And in the hand, the flagship Ryzen 7 950X feature 16 core and 32 thread, 5.7 GHz of boost clock, a base clock of 4.5 GHz, 64 MB of cache and 170 watts of TDP. Also, the price are quite a bit dissimilar, with a 7600X at a MSRP of $299, the 7700X is around the $400, $549 for 7900X and the 7950X at $150 more than the 7900X. The motherboard is equipped with a 4 new DDR5 DIMM dual channel memory architecture socket. Here we can install in a minimum of 32GB for single DIMM memory module up to a maximum capacity of 128GB for all DIMM. The memories that can be used can be an operating base frequency of 4800 MHz up to over 5600 MHz in overclocking. Continuing to the motherboard layout internal connection, starting from left, on top we have got a 8-pin ATX 12V power connector for our CPU, CPU fan header and CPU fan optional header. After going down on the right, there are two addressable Gen 2 headers, a 24-pin ATX main power socket connector, and a USB 3.2 Gen 1 header, and a USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-C front panel header, and a 4 SATA 3 6GB to second port. The bottom, the mobile has a speaker connector, a system panel header, including system power LED header, storage devices activity LED header, power button, and a reset button header. After our 4 SATA 3 6GB to second port, COM debug header, 2 USB 2.0 connector, SPDIF outboard, a 3rd addressable Gen 2 connector, our RGB header, COM debug header, and our 2 chassis fan connector, clear CMOS header and the front panel audio header. On top of all PCI Express, near the audio jack of the back IO panel, there is a chassis fan header, and finally, at the center of it, we have got a SPI TPM header. The storage options of a new B650 motherboard are composed to 8 SATA of 3 6GB to second connector and 2 M.2 slots, including 1 M.2 socket support storage devices type 2242-2260 or 2280 PCI Express Gen 5.0 operating at a 4-4 mode, and 1 M.2 socket support storage devices type 2242-2260 and 2280 PCI Express Gen 4 operating at a 4-4 mode. As expansion slot, the Asus board uses 4 PCI Express. Among these, there are 1 PCI Express 4.0 for 16 slot operating at a 4-1 mode, and the other 3 PCI Express 4.0 for 16 slot, this time whereas operating at a 4-1 mode. The audio compartment mounts the Realtek 7.1 surrounding sound high definition audio codec. It supports jack detection, multi-streaming, and front panel jack retasking. In addition, it is characterized by audio shielding, premium audio capacitor, and dedicated audio PCB layers. On back, the I/O panel feature firstly a video graphics adapter port, a HDMI port, a display port, a BIOS flashback button with which updated easily, PS2 combo port for whatever keyboard and mouse use this connector, 2 USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports, a USB 2.0 port with a BIOS flashback support, an USB 2.0 port, 2.5GB per second Ethernet port, and USB 3.2 Gen 2 operating up to 10GB to second port, Wi-Fi 6 port, and the audio jacks including line-in port, line-out port, and the microphone port. There is to note the presence of a non-USB port, really a pity. But now it is time to talk about the price. The motherboard is available on retailers at a price of about $200 or 260 euros at the time of making this video. And as always, I leave you the link to buy it in the description below. Alright, that's all for today. I hope you're enjoying and helpful today's videos. As always, let me know what do you think in the comments below, leave a like, share it with all your friends, and don't forget to subscribe. Huge thanks for watching, see you again next time.